Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is just to give the meaning of the word abide. We say abide in God and abide in Christ. What do you mean by saying these words? It is actually what the Bible means that, or we say something else. Now our Sunday school, or from our pulpits, the abiding is started in a very simple way. They say, ask Jesus to come in your heart and Jesus will be in your heart. Or they say, Jesus is knocking at your door of your heart, and open your heart and receive him inside our hearts, and then he will be in. And the abiding is done quickly. That's it. You believe that he abides in you, he abides in you. What is the proof that he is in our hearts? They say, just believe that he is in our hearts without doubting, and if your heart believes it, that is the confirmation. It is so easy. If we live in sin, then what? Still, they say, still he will be faithful, and he said that he will never forsake you and leave you. So they will quote such verses, then God is faithful despite we commit sin. But such manipulations of scriptures are counterfeit abiding. It's not the true abiding, they are deception. Then what is the true abiding? Jesus Christ says in John chapter 10 verse 30, I and my Father are one. They both abide in each other as one. That is the abiding. A prayer of Jesus Christ is recorded in the entire 17th chapter of the book of John. He mentions in verses 6 and 9, this way, verse 6, I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest to me out of the world. He took them out of the world and he gave it to Jesus. Thine they are, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept the word. These people kept the word of God. That means they live according to the word of God. Verse 9 say, I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast sent me, for they are thine. In verse 6, there is a group who kept the word of God, and they are the people of God. In verse 9, he says that he prays to God only for them, but not for the world. In verse 21, he prays that they all may be one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us. So, here Jesus Christ desires that these people who have kept the word of God must abide in God as are in the same way as Jesus and God the Father were one. So keeping his word is a prerequisite to his abiding, and it's very respect, very valued for the abiding. Asking God to come in our heart and believing that he's in us and chanting cliches and such things are fake and they are deception. In John chapter 15 verse 4, Jesus Christ say, abide in me. John chapter, abide in me and I in thee, I in you. Jesus tells his disciples to live in him or within his word, within his commandment. Live, abide by the word, abide by him. But as God, he is spirit. How can we live in a spirit? We cannot live in a spirit. That's why he says it is by keeping his word that you live according to his word or his commandments. And it says, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abides in the vine, no more can you except you abide in me. That's what he says. That means you compare to the vine and the branch. The vine means the plant, and the branch is the branches which attach to that. We have to abide, so they have to stick with each other, because to get the juice from the life and the food and everything is from the vine. Then and then only you can live. the branch cannot be alive or cannot yield the fruit if it is not attached firmly with the plant as one. So also, we are not, if you are not attached with Jesus and His Word, by His Word rather, we will not yield fruits of righteousness. His fruit is the fruit of righteousness. That is, we will not live a godly life, or we cannot live a godly life. Verse 5, I am the vine, and you are the branches. That he that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. So if we live in Jesus Christ, and he lives in us, then we will do the works of God. That is, we will speak His word. What He spoke, we will speak, and what the way He lived, we live. It is not for that, and we cannot live like He lived. Verse 6, if a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If we do not live in Him, that is, if we do not live according to His word, then we will not yield the fruits, and we will be removed from Him. The result is, and we will be burned in the lake of fire, will be rejected for eternity. Verse 7, if you abide in me, this is Jesus was saying, and my words abide in you, you shall ask whatever you will, and it shall be done unto you. That is, if we live according to the words of Jesus Christ, then we may say that if we obey according to His commandments, and that is abiding in Him, then whatever you ask, and God says it's a big promise, and it is God says He'll give it to you. That is the proof of our abiding, of His abiding with us, our abiding with Him. But the hint is, since you abide in His word, you will not ask beyond the limitations of the word. Whatever's in the world, according to the word, you will ask things. He will give those to you. He will grant those to you as you ask. So, if you abide in God, we will do what He tells us to do, and He will also give us whatever we ask Him. So, abide in Him. This is what the abiding is. And it is not by telling cliches, but it is by keeping His word. Thank you for listening. May God bless you and be with you. Amen.